We have been requested by the users of ECG Corner to produce a series of short videos describing the different types of accessory pathways. In this first video, we explain the concept of accessory pathway. Since the publication in 1906 of the work of Sunao Tawara on the conduction system of the mammalian heart, we know that the propagation of the electrical impulses from the atria to the ventricles is via an axis formed by the AV node, the bundle of His, and the bundle branches, the right and the left bundle branch. The bundle branches are connected to the working ventricular myocardium through the Purkinje network. We consider as accessory pathways three types of intracardiac connections apart from the normal AV bundle or AV node His axis. The first type of anomalous connection are the so-called atrioventricular accessory pathways that connect the atrial and the ventricular myocardium at sites where both type of myocardial tissues should be electrically and anatomically isolated. The second type of accessory pathways connect the atrial myocardium with elements of the normal AV bundle below the AV node. Examples of these are the atriohesian connections and also the atriofascicular connections. Finally, the third type of accessory pathways are connections between the AV node and the ventricles, or novoventricular connections, and the connections between the fascicular system and the ventricle, the so-called fasciculoventricular connections. Accessory pathways that may result in ventricular pre-excitation are, first, the atrioventricular accessory pathways. Second, the atriofascicular accessory pathways. Third, the nodoventricular accessory pathways. And finally, the so-called fasciculoventricular accessory pathways. The first atrioventricular accessory pathways were described by Stanley Kent, although his work was bitterly criticized by the opinion leaders in heart pathology and physiology of the beginning of the 20th century. In spite of these criticisms, the term bundle of Kent was used by Wolferth and Wood in 1933 to explain the electrocardiogram of patients with the WPW syndrome and also the mechanism of the most frequent type of non-pre-excited tachycardia developed by these patients. Ivan Mahaim, in the 1940s, described connections between the AV node or the bundle of His and the summit of the interventricular septum and between the divisions of the bundle of His and the ventricular myocardium. These are the true Mahaim fibers, the nodoventricular or fasciculoventricular connections. Watch the part 2 of this series of videos on classification criteria for accessory pathways.